Hello and welcome to this module about cognition. Much of the current legislation and standards on web accessibility focus on being able to physically access digital services through the senses, whether it is hearing, vision or touch. However, for a large part of the population, the difficulty is rather in the next step, that is how to understand and interact with the information. This is what cognition is about. Cognitive functions concern mental processes for taking in, sorting and interpreting information. And in fact, at all times, our senses are constantly sending in information to the brain and asking it to make a decision about what to do with the information it has collected. Is it too cold? Should I put a sweater on? What about this loud background noise that I hear? Should I do something about it? And what about the text that I'm reading? What should I do with it? And for some people, these kind of processes can be more difficult in certain circumstances. And for all of us, we can have difficulty with understanding information and knowing what to do with it in a situation of cognitive overload when we receive a lot of information from the senses at the same time. So cognitive accessibility is about avoiding situations of cognitive overload and helping the brain to sort out and understand the information it receives from the senses. In this section, we will learn more about who can be in extra need of cognitive accessibility, and we will also look at some concrete examples of needs and solutions in the digital world.